Dylan from Foresight here, down at beautiful Brooklyn, just off the Old Pacific Highway. Very exciting day today. We're gonna be having our first demo event in over 6 months at Pie in the Sky. We've had over 600 responses to the Facebook event. We're expecting a massive turnout today. We're gonna have some existing customers come through, catch up with them, talk about their experience, get some reactions from some riders that are seeing the helmet for the first time. We've got Aiden Hayes, our ASBK Supersport sponsored rider, on deck as well to talk about his experience. And yeah, we just can't wait to get stuck in and meet some riders. Let's go. Darren is an absolute nutcase, and that's one of the few people you could say that to, and it's actually a compliment. So Darren's got a custom little bike building thing going on, Insanity Customs, and he's brought in his highly modified BMW S1000RR. Why don't you first of all just talk about what the heck is going on here?
Set up for street, but mainly drags. So it's S1000RR, stretched, car tire on the back, nitrous, just a little bit different.
What kind of quarter mile times are you running?
9.83 is my best.
Right, yeah. Anything under 10 seconds is blisteringly quick.
That's so, without the nitrous.
That's without the nitrous, yeah. Jesus.
And now I've got the problem with wheel spin, so going full slick.
All right, so you, how long have you had your helmet for? Remind us, sort of.
Be 12 months.
Sum up your Foresight experience so far.
Well, for one, done the Salt Lakes and can't use GoPros. Same with the drags, very hard to use the GoPros. So now with this, it's a whole new ball game. Absolutely love it. So, and service, unbelievable.
Look, I had very strong or fast bikes in Europe, and I downsized, and I'm happy with it.
Sure.
Because I can't afford to pay the fines here.
Right.
And so I used to speed in Europe, really. If you get 100 over, they don't kill you.
Don't incriminate yourself.
They don't kill you. But here, it's, look, it helps. If you just miss the speed sign and you get the warning, yep, it's good.
What did you think?
Like it, really comfortable. Like all the electronic sort of aids you got in it, which, yep, is good.
So you had the demo?
Yeah, I had the demo.
What did you think, excellent, of the LED array?
Awesome. Yeah, it'd be handy.
Yeah.
Really good, really, really good. Radio side of it, mate, we use it all the time.
Yeah,
on the phone and that sort of thing. So
it's nice to have, yeah, it all tucked away and,
yeah,
integrated.
Yeah, tucked away, yeah, integrated into it, so it'd be good.
What alert interests you most? Do you get the speed cameras, or would you use it for navigation? Or?
Speed cameras, please.
Yeah, that's usually the common answer.
So. Yeah.
It performs excellent, not only just in the comfort, but in giving us some feedback on how we're going out there. We can look at different lines when we're on the bike, and it's just so clear when we come back in that we can look at the footage as well as see other, where the other riders are going, to see what I've done different, and then we can compare it to our lap times.
Yeah.
Well, he's taking this line, you're taking that line, maybe try this or that.
Yeah, I suppose you've got a big advantage over everyone else, kind of tailing riders and seeing what they're doing. And
yep. And we can also see things on the dash that, like, I might not actually see, you know. We can look at things and go, oh, this happened at this point, and just look back on it. And not only that, it's just getting us all data the whole time we're out there.
Yeah, that's awesome insight. Getting off the track and being able to show your friends and family what it's like to be on a race bike. What's the reaction when you show people?
It's pretty surprising. They especially, everyone loves to see a crash. So even in the pits, like, you come back and if,
well,
you,
that's it. Yeah, you had that pretty bloody hairy 220k an hour, yeah, at Goulburn on turn one there.
Turn one, yeah.
What was the consensus when you were showing people?
Well,
that
everyone liked it. Yeah, it catches everything. You can't hide.
But that electronics module that was in that shell, so. We've talked about it in other videos. The electronics module in the front is independent from the shell. So Aiden crashed on the racetrack at 220 k's an hour. He set that helmet back to us. We took that E-module out, put it in a new shell, and then you had it back in a week to use in another race.
With the helmet, like you would think that with all the device that's in it, you would expect it to be a fair bit heavier, but it's not. We've compared it. We actually, the first weekend I had it, we had it with the other guys who I raced with against their carbon helmets that don't have anything else in them, and it was like, it was not much weight difference whatsoever, and I was surprised. I thought, oh, there'd be a bit of difference, but it's not.
Yeah, that's so cool, man. We love hearing stuff like that, you know, because racing is something that we just love being a part of. Soaking up the atmosphere of the track is unreal, and yeah.
Love it.
Thanks, man. We appreciate you coming out. Saw it for the first time and touched it and sort of looked at the tech, what was your first reaction?
Immediately, yeah, I had to get involved, get behind it. The biggest point for me was the camera. I like doing track days. I like filming everywhere I go. I run, you know, action cams on the motorbike. Had it originally on the side of the helmet. Wanted to steer away from that. I work in a hospital. Surgeons are saying that you're crazy wearing helmets. You know, you've got people like Schumacher and so forth that had those accidents wearing action cams on their helmets, and that was in a skiing accident. Nowhere near the speeds or impact that you can get on a motorcycle. Whereas this is intrinsically built into it, so that safety aspect of it, you know, really appealed to me.
What would you say about sort of the Foresight community and sort of being part of the group and the way that, you know, the development's kind of...
Yeah, the awesome thing about it is that how much involvement the founders and the pioneers or any customer, future customers, have into the development of the helmet. It's awesome. You're not going to get that from anyone else. So many suggestions that have been made through the community have actually been implemented or are on their way, you know, being implemented and all that sort of stuff. So that's a testament to you guys at Foresight, listening to the community, getting us involved. It's about 10,000 kilometres I've racked up in this helmet now. So, and the way that it's held up is awesome.
So obviously being one of our founding customers, would have joined sort of halfway through 2019, yep. What was it like to kind of see it come through like that and then be able to buy one?
Yeah, it was amazing. I actually tried to buy one online the night before, but the system crashed and no one could buy one.
Yeah, oh man.
So I jumped in the car, drove to London Raceway, a couple of hours driving. Amazing product, and I must say that customer service is unbelievable with you guys. Any little hassles, fixed straight away. You know, new cheek pads, done. Order them online, done straight, sent straight out. Amazing, amazing customer support, and the helmet itself is brilliant.
All right, guys, that's a wrap on today. Man, what an amazing event. What a great turnout. So many good conversations. We had 70 helmets go online for sale today. They were sold out in about half an hour. So look, thank you to everyone that purchased. Thank you to everyone that came out, and we'll see you in the next one real soon.